Next question is, sum of the areas of two squares is 468 meter square. If the difference of their perimeters is 24 meter, find the sides of two squares. So the question says about two squares. And in the first sentence, it says about sum of areas of two squares. So we are going to take the side of the squares as x and y. The first square is having the side of x units. And the second square is having the units of y units. So here the unit is clearly mentioned there, meter. So x meters and y meter. Area of two squares. What is the area of the side with the side x meter? It is x square, isn't it? Area of the first square will be x square and area of the second square will be y square, because side square is a formula to find area of a square. Sum of the areas of two squares. How we can write sum means squares, area we got as x square and y square. Sum of the areas means what we can write as x square plus y square is given as 468. Let that be equation number 1. That is what we get from the first one. What about the next one? Difference of their perimeters is 24 meter. What is the formula to find perimeter of a square? Perimeter of a square is 4 into side. So if the side of the first square is x, what is the perimeter? 4 into x. And what about the second perimeter? 4 into y. Okay, so what's the second sentence? Difference of their perimeter. Perimeters we got as 4x and 4y. Difference of the perimeter means 4x minus 4y is given as 24. Okay, divide throughout the equation with the 4. So what we get is x minus y is equal to 24 by 4 gives you 6. From this equation, what is the value of x? X is equal to 6 plus y. Let this be equation number 2. Again, what we are going to do next is we are substituting second equation in the first one. So instead of x here, we will replace it by 6 plus y. So substituting second equation in the first one, what we get is 6 plus y the whole square. First term is x square. Instead of x, we put the value 6 plus y. So 6 plus y square plus y square is equal to 468. Open the bracket. This is of the form a plus b the whole square. What is a plus b the whole square? A square, that is 6 square, which is 36, plus 2ab, 2 into 6 into y, which is 12y, plus b square is y square, plus again a y square is there. You have to write it is equal to 468. Y square plus y square gives you 2y square plus 12y. And what about the constant? 36 minus 468. 36 minus 468. That means we have to subtract 36 from 468. What will be the answer? 468 minus 36 gives you 432. Minus 432. Why? Because when we take 468 to the left side, it becomes negative, is equal to 0. Again, this equation also we can simplify by dividing throughout with the 2. So what we get is y square plus 6y minus 216 is equal to 0. Okay, again we will solve for y. How? This is a quadratic equation, so find b square minus 4ac. We can apply any of the method. So 6 square minus 4 into 1 into minus 216. 6 square is 36 plus 216 into 4. Try it out. 216 into 4 is 6 was 24. 4 into 1 is 4. 4 plus 2 6. 4 into 2 is 8. 864. And what about 864 plus 36? The answer will be 900. So we are getting b square minus 4ac as 900. What we have to do again? Y is equal to, the equation is in terms of y. So y is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. That is the formula. So minus b will be minus 6 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac we got as 900 divided by 2 into a is 1. Okay, that is equal to minus 6 plus or minus, two zeros came inside the square root. So when we take the square root, there will be only one zero. And the balance digit is 9. What's the square root of 9? 3. So square root of 900 is 30 divided by 2. Split the terms. Y is equal to minus 6 plus 30 by 2. Or y is equal to minus 6 minus 30 divided by 2. Minus 6 plus 30 by 2 gives you 24 by 2, which is 12. And from here we are getting y as minus 36 by 2, which is equal to minus 18. This must be rejected. Why? Because we took y as the side of the second square, isn't it? Side cannot be a negative value. So we have to take y as 12. So we got the side of the second square as 12. And how we will get x? We have a relation connecting x and y. From the second equation, we are getting x equal to 6 plus y. That is 6 + 12, which gives you 18 meters. So the answer is side of the squares are, we took the squares, sides of the squares as x and y. So we got the value of x as 18 meter and y as 12 meter. So the answer is 18 meter and 12 meter.